Greetings. Welcome to Legacy of Worlds. I am Tomekeeper Devon, and I just want to take some time to thank those who make this show possible. Hero Forge, WizKids, KP11 Studios, Foam Brain Games, and of course, Lynn Vander themselves. But now, the adventure and the stories unfold.
You want a train?
You're on a train.
Almost there.
Almost there.
Wait.
Lightning rail would not have brakes in the rails.
Yeah.
It would not have brakes.
No, it would just be like a
whoosh, yeah. Whoosh. Sorry. Boom. You're nailing.
Right.
All right. That's our new clip.
Tickly, tickly. You have obtained the rogue card. And with it, Jarlaxle infused, the essence infused.
You got a Jarlaxle in your pocket.
That's right. And but you are still on the lightning rail, and there are some interesting questions. Of course, Melf having exited with old Morty of the Kynan. The questions that some of the rail officers had about the damages in the back, everyone was just kind of like, oh, I mean, the guy just left, he's gone.
Yeah.
Because the train comes to the next stop, everybody has to get off because now they've got to do all these repairs and everything.
Yeah.
Any legal questions that might have been brought up were immediately stifled by the fact that Baron Merrick's Decaneth.
Absolutely. Here, you can contact.
Those damn malfunctions.
Yeah.
Just the generators. You know, sometimes there's that static shock, and
I would just switch that last car out of the train and leave it on the siding for someone else to deal with it later.
Well, you know, train cars do fall off the track sometimes.
That's true. And as we're walking out to cop, grab him on the elbow. Thank you very much for your services. I recommend you writing a very good review from Merrick's and a suggestion.
I thought we're trying to be on the down low here.
No, he did that.
Yeah.
Anyhow, good job. You know, get yourself something nice.
Yes, you could disembark off the train here at the next stop, or you could stay on and let it
Middletown
to.
Honestly. I don't think. Well, I guess we are probably close enough. How close are we? If we're in Valinor, we're southern. There's no reason to get off the train.
Eventually take you up near the moorland.
Right. I mean, so that's what I'm saying. Let's stay on the train.
It's way back around to Talentia, right?
Yeah. So that's my point. Is we may as well actually stay on the train as we come up with our next plan. So.
Just stay on the train.
So that's another long rest, is what you're telling me.
Mm-hmm. If we don't decide to
how long of a train ride is that?
So let's talk about it.
A good while. while.
4 hours?
At least 4 hours.
Jeez.
Long rest for me, my friend.
Oh, heck yeah.
All right. You're not going all the way back to Talentia. You're going to get off.
But before we do any rest, I mean, hold on a moment. Because like I said, the other possibility is teleportation doesn't take any time at all.
Mm-hmm.
So my question is, there's no reason to get off the train because we aren't walking there from here.
Oh, that's a shame.
But on the other hand, now that we are on the train headed in the right direction, let's talk about, like, are we waiting? Are we jumping there? So, Heartbreaker, knowing that you got a potentially a lovely rest in your future, do you want to try that card trick again?
Which card trick?
Locate.
Oh, well, we know where we want to go.
We know generally where we want to go. Do we have specific details?
I mean, probably it was mainly just, it's in the Moorlands.
That's what I'm saying. The Moorlands is huge. Like, without some kind of narrowing down, that's not going
to
help us.
I need to be much closer to do it.
Well, you could. What you would want to do. What you would want to do is you'd want to look at the data on the Sensory Stone and then basically look and say, well, yeah, it's in the Moorlands, but like, where specifically?
That's what I'm asking.
Is there like, is it east, north, south, west?
If you will allow me to do this, so I will do it.
Yeah.
Okay. So I will.
I don't see this being.
Oh, sorry. That's the whole card. Perfect. I will get that one.
I will hold the cards that I do have already.
Here's the one. No, it's the hold again. I couldn't resist. All right. Sorry.
The amber scales of Merrick's jacket just shimmer slightly.
I didn't know. No one's commented on my fine.
I did so much.
I'm
in my theater world as best as I can.
You know, I'm going to do.
But it's not a material orc.
I appreciate that. I'm going to have a Chimeras line.
Do the underwear, man.
I'm talking to Club Decker about a new line here.
Oh yeah.
Or some things. All right.
I'm concentrating, sort of, with interruption and. Really?
No. You're gonna die.
Cannot blame it on them.
That is rude.
I'm going to curse you.
It is part of the natural fight. You know, you're not already. I've been fighting all the time.
Okay, I was about to say, yeah, you're all in with the wholeness of body.
I can't wait to see what the end episode of today looks like.
I don't know what you think at any point.
When you wake up, you will just have to run the game.
I don't know what you think a key point looks like. I mean, I do have to say, with your invisibility and such, we've always known that you are silent but deadly.
I appreciate the compliment.
Of course. All right.
On the resume.
I am
concentrating. It's been gas, guys.
It will exactly
get them all out now.
So it does give you a location, specifically in the Moorland, which means nothing to you until you explain to Merrick.
This means nothing to me.
But Merrick, you would recognize the location as the ruins of Eston.
So we were thinking that maybe we should go to Mystara, right?
You don't want to go get the one here while we're already here.
What is wrong with this place?
Do I know some that you're basically...
Oh, for sure. No, 100%. I mean, anyone with a passive insight of anything would notice that. So, immediate reaction.
What is the problem? Is this where the Lord of Blades is?
No. At least I hope not.
What is the ruins of Eston?
Eston was the heart of House Kenneth before the war.
Oh, this sounds good for you.
Where I grew up.
Oh.
Where you were tortured as youth.
Oh.
Well, I mean, the test of Sybaris to get your dragon mark to activate is
high school.
It has to induce stressful conditions, and maybe some people don't survive, but you know, it's an important part of our corporate culture.
Did you speculate that this was going to be where it was?
No. Was this obviously, I would have thought maybe the Lord of Blades again. It is a place of wonders. I have to say, Sharn is, even with all the work I've done over the last 20 years, just a pale shadow of what we made in Eston. But
it sounds all good.
I don't believe it's the same.
I haven't been there since the morning, and a part of me doesn't want to see what it's become.
Since the morning, that it would change that quickly?
I believe you meant morning.
More
there. Oh. There. I forget. Not everyone is familiar with my world. There was a disaster 4 years ago. My people were caught in a great war that had lasted for decades with no signs of victory, too closely matched, no one willing to compromise, until the nation of Seer was destroyed within a day. A mist boiled out of the Palace of Metron, swept across the land, twisting and transforming everything caught in its path.
Could it be Ravenloft? The mists from there?
There's a possibility. That's a whole story. There is a piece of Seer trapped that I... I don't think this is the right time for this. It is not.
It is not in relation to this, though, because...
No, it is not. They are not the mists of... But there are similarities. But what was left behind... The morning, we don't know what it was. We still don't know. Was it a weapon? Some people think, though there's absolutely no proof the morning was man-made, some people think that it was the result of all of the war magics, the forces that were being unleashed over so long essentially tore the world apart. All I can say, as we've been conducting as much research as we can over the last 20 years, is it is entirely unpredictable. Everything has changed in different ways. No one set of conclusions. So again, I do not know what we will find. I know, among other things, magic behaves unpredictably. There are places where weapons of war, the magic within them, a siege staff, burst into just a creature of pure flame, or like a cloud kill spell, frozen and just brought to life. The things we could find there, I don't even know.
We must be on guard.
We are too close. We should do this.
We have to get it eventually, so we might as well get it now. We just take as much care and precaution as possible. Also, look what we've dealt with so far.
The tidy wizard in me already
disintegrate.
Shrinks, yes, at having to leave.
That's the tiny wizard on me.
And having to leave a card behind in Athas rather than finishing the job.
I did not know that. I thought this was done in the workshop and whatever, and seen by us all.
Well, he hasn't, you know, I haven't always brought him out, but yes, I will bring Little
when
Stinky out.
When you bring him out,
you want a card? Here's a card. He hands out. He has a tiny card, which actually says, "Stinker, homunculus of Shadowdale."
At least, like, very visibly, doesn't want to have anything to do.
Can I play with for a minute?
Yeah, here, you take that. Sorry, I should have thought of that. I'm sorry.
Help me!
Are you all right?
Disintegrate, my little.
Something.
Are you going to teach him a new spell?
Should not.
I am.
We'll talk about this later.
Why does this bother you?
To create life from nothing, to mess with the nature.
Are you a little nothing? Are you?
To create monsters?
Monster.
I agree. I do not see monsters. To say that life, just because it is not what others see, that it is born in a different way.
Don't have to live it.
My father, I have lived it for 30 years. My father brought an entire people into the world from nothing. And I have been struggling.
Oh yeah, bite me. Bite me.
To give them a better life, to make the world a better place. And you can see from the Lord of Blades how well that's worked out. But I'm just saying,
exactly.
I can't.
That is part of my point, but also, you don't know when you make a creature what kind of life it is going to be tortured with forever.
I agree that changing a living creature, twisting something, is different from creating life, because we create life as humans every day. We bring new life into the world.
That is
nature. Or we practice.
This is not, this wasn't
weird
ever
science. Yeah.
Life is more about free will and choice rather than where we come from. And
how do you have free will and choice if you are not allowed to? Yeah,
yeah. I love to hear it.
Live naturally.
Did you see?
Office,
we're trying to give them lives. We're trying to help them find ways that they can reproduce.
We'll see.
I mean, we cannot control the circumstances in which we come into this world, but
what we had to go through to just make me okay. As okay as I could ever possibly be living like this. What did we have to go through together to make this happen when I should never have had this happen to me in the first place? You should have just let me die.
But that's exactly it. It was done to you. You were born, and then someone took your life and changed it. I'm saying that there are 10,000 people here in my world today who would not exist if my father hadn't pushed beyond the bounds of science. They wouldn't have existed at all. They wouldn't have had any life.
Oh, maybe they shouldn't. Maybe there wouldn't be so much tax on your magical resources if there weren't all these extra people.
Well,
it is a discussion for another time, but keep that little thing away from me.
Oh, you want to come back to
Sorry, Stinky. Look, no, understood. I do.
Feeble mind.
All right.
Feeble mind.
Oh, shoot. That's bad news. I don't like that at all.
I have
don't say. Okay. You didn't teach him to do it, did you?
No.
But
maybe.
All right.
Sorry, is that you? I don't know if you could hear him, but the whole time he was going, wait.
Oh, I can hear him.
That was a great scene.
All right.
Oh, my God. That was a great scene. By the way, he's not laughing like a buffoon in high school. That was Tommy laughing at Ed. Lowell was remaining stoic the entire time. He's actually was staring at an empty seat in the cart and was listening to the conversation, but also like almost a little down. So
no, and for the record, Merrick's was already chicken up by Eston. I mean, he was taking what you were saying very seriously and was like sort of literally clearly had not thought about this in creating Little Stinky, and Tony was like, oh shit, yeah, wow, that's a, you know, so we want to have another conversation about this, for sure.
I mean, but she would go on to tell you, like, I spent decades in penance for helping with creations like this, and still am tortured to this day by having to live like I do, but only escaped because of sheer luck and friendship.
I have to say, the time I spent in that place, where you were born, where you were changed.
Well, I wasn't born there, but I was reborn there for sure.
That is a place where science is used in terrible and cruel ways. And I cannot deny that in the past, in my world, in the war, we also made terrible mistakes and did things that shouldn't have been done. But I also have to believe that our work can make our world better. That we can. The Warforged were made as soldiers, and that is wrong. But I do want to try to give them a place in the world, to give them the lives that they deserve.
They grow
and
up
I still
so
believe
fast.
That we can. And I have met so many people who would not exist if not for my father.
The Warforged are different because you are not killing people and you are truly using your science and technology to create something which I know you want to be something good. I don't know about this thing, but I know you're probably not killing people or defiling bodies and desecrating.
This is worth talking. And again, yeah, No. That happens. I'm just saying, that's a thing. But this is worth noting. Stinky.
He's so cute.
He is not actually alive in the way we
know. No, I saw the dog.
He is a spirit. But this is what I'm saying is, he is a temporary spirit that has been embodied in this. You know, he's going to get blown up a bunch of times. I'm just telling you. I can see that happening. And I can just put him back, and the spirit will come back in. It's not, he's not like a Warforged. He's not like you or I. It is
not like a flesh homunculus.
I want to be a real one. Yeah, he's not a flesh homunculus at all. He's a doll, like, and he's made of, he's made of hellworm hide, adamantine, and doll parts. So there's nothing, the Warforged are alive. Even though they were never, they are not me.
And his beard is made from strands.
He's just made from, he's a toy. Hey, that's something.
If I can just say one thing. In the time, very short time, that I've been with you all, regardless of where you've come from, or what, how you were created, or what you have done in the past, what I have seen of you and your actions so far have more than defined anything else and your origins could possibly tell me. You have taken this path to protect, to save, to preserve. And that is your choice. Mm. And that is who you are, to me at least. And I hope you see that yourself. That whatever reason that you were, as you said, were created or reborn, every other step you have taken since has been your own path.
Meris, you've been to Imaria enough to know that not every Aetherian is an empirical evil. Adira changed you. Everybody changes. I've shirked the duties of the crown for how long? Only to find my own devices at play to find a way to unite people, but I never revealed my plan. So many people died under the fact that I never took that crown.
I have to say, you were an inspiration to me, actually, in that, over these last 20 years. Again, we made the Warforged as weapons. We sold them. That's, looking back on it, I don't know if that's something that can ever be forgiven. But also, we brought them into this world, and that is a good. I have met so many people who are some of the most, the best people I know, who were amazing. And it is not easy on my world. There are those who follow, you know, who have never forgiven us, the Lord of Blades, and those who follow him who still hold that we can never be forgiven for what we did. But in Sharn, I have been trying to make a home, to make a better life for the things that we created. And honestly, that's seeing you, seeing Melf, feeling that I can't just ignore, can't just make a dollar. No, I'm gonna. I mean, making money is the best way to help, you know, I can, to help give people a better life.
If it wasn't for you, I would never have escaped. And so I know that you and your science can help people.
And if it wasn't for you, I never would have escaped, and we wouldn't have had that force wall when meteor swarm was dropped on us.
Think of it this way, little Stinky. Have no choice coming into existence, just as human babies have no choice.
Wait,
but we fight.
I didn't have a choice.
We fight for them to have choices.
That's right.
As all this conversation happens, you just see a nice little tear come down.
They've already passed the first lesson without any instructions.
Okay, I'm on the way. Right, Merrick, you
will succeed in your goal. We will succeed in your goal.
This has been a great trip down memory lane. And you can see he's trying to pull a little calm emotions on himself.
He taps you on the shoulder and
we can just sit on all that. I believe a wise person told me we should be focused on getting the cards.
Yes.
Reading.
So,
here's the personal thing. Reading.
Holy cow.
I don't...
Well, we're screwed.
What do we got?
Well,
cast away negativity.
We are not. We are trying to do that, but there's...
I think that's the cards telling us enough. Get on with it. We get it. You've been through pain.
The card is being like, "Let's go. You're halfway through. Let's get to the Borderlands."
Yep. Are you doing the reading?
Sure.
Hand we are cards. Not going to be able to cast all of this negativity away until we deal with something much larger, something that is all-encompassing. This sword that we saw, I see this very large snake that is wrapped around it. There's something entangling it, a very large destruction of something before we are able to do that. And it says that we are unable to find love, but this love does not mean love in this context. It doesn't always. It usually doesn't actually mean love. It means a connection to something. So right now, the connection that you might be looking to find where we are going is probably not going to be that one. I mean, I can't say for sure, but knowing what we've faced so far, my intuition says no, but something even bigger is coming. And then we are going to come to a point where we think we know what we are facing, but it is going to be different. And it all starts with this very large obstruction. It's taking the form in my vision as a snake, but
these readings are very creepy.
It is wrapped around this sword, which I believe is this Rennick sword.
Perhaps.
Maybe.
That's There's what I have, but we have to go get it weapons. Anyway.
Large weapons we might find. So, the thing that we do have has our advantage. I don't want to go here, but I have certainly know it well. So, if you can...
Protect Americans.
Well, also, what I meant is if I can share my vision of it with you, we can probably go directly there, which is a very big thing because you don't want to walk through the Mornland if you can avoid it.
That's good.
So...
Do you still need some rest, though?
That's the question.
I mean,
we can take 4 hours. Well, what I'm saying is we're going to teleport off.
I just need to sit here.
Yeah, we can take 4 hours to... Because I don't actually need a long rest.
They say
I know where you're at.
We already got a long rest, didn't we?
No.
You had one...
We had right one, before we had one at...
Like, we didn't
get charred.
Yeah, you had one at Charn.
So I didn't do much like with Jarlaxle.
The thing with Jarlaxle didn't burn
no, me. No, both threw a lightning bolt at, like, there was some...
I used that wand of Wonder Wish does
not. Wand. Yeah, like, there were some things used, right. But not enough that would probably...
Right. I think we're okay.
So you don't need a rest.
Right. Yeah, that's right.
That's right. Oh, well, so given that, you know, basically, if you want to use Detect Thoughts and then... Or I can use Detect Thoughts, yeah, I don't know, you know, but basically, I can share a vision... of Estyn, you know, the gates of Estyn.
Let's
and
do that.
Then you can
and just to teleport. Be clear, this is going to be what they looked like before the morning.
That is absolutely
24 years ago.
That is why I am very much going to try and pick a space. I'm not going to be like,
very identifiable.
Right. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to go into the hall, you know, because who knows if that building is even standing. Storage. I'm going to try and pick, you know,
sort of
the plaza, sort
Where
of
was close the water to
the clockwork menagerie, you know, sort of the a large open area that, like, even with things falling is probably still...
Okay.
If that works.
Does yeah. that make sense? No, I think that's fine. I'm going to consider that very familiar.
Mm. Yeah.
So because it is somewhere that you're very familiar with, but it will not be as accurate as it would otherwise.
Well, of course, because I'm sharing it
because it's
as well.
Yeah, the morning changed.
Yeah, and I have to say honestly, I don't have a lot of experience with teleportation in the morning. And as I said, part of the risk here is that the morning is unpredictable. Magic may not work, you know, much as the experience we had when we met you, there may be unpredictable effects. A very common one, so this is an important one to keep in mind because it's one of the most common things we have discovered is healing either not working at all or being only partially effective. So be cautious about being hurt. So other than that, just trying to say things to expect, basically expect the unexpected. You know, I can't tell you as much as I could.
Such is life. It's unpredictable. So
let's try to maybe... Oh, I'm sorry. Go.
Oh, I was just saying we should always predict the unpredictable.
That's very wise.
Ooh. Yeah.
That I want
was,
that off.
That how monkish of you.
I did have one for you, but I will tell you later.
Okay.
I would like it in a cookie, please.
Oh, is that a method of marketing? I can do that, yes.
Yeah, we can do
we
that.
We can teach the monkly ways.
Okay, if we get out of this alive, I know a guy at House Gamanda. Oh. We can totally make this happen. Monk munches, I love it. I'll give you 2%. Yeah. Okay. This is gonna be a thing. We're gonna make this happen.
Let's get in there and get this card.
Well, I don't know. We might want to act on this monk munches thing. Maybe we can come back to the card. You know. No. Okay. Fine. Fine.
I feel
fine.
Like if there is no world to have people eat this cookie, we would have a very bad business plan.
That's going on a cookie, by the way.
Yes.
Just that way.
World
there.
Is important before business.
Yeah.
Put that on the poster.
Yeah.
I did want to say that.
Let's do this, my Mel.
Everybody has a chance.
You see it?
Not
oh, yeah.
All right.
You grew up there?
Yeah.
Where did you play?
Well, we played actually in the manufacturing facility.
Oh that explains that,
the
much.
Way, yeah.
While that's happening, we'll just.
Oh, I was just going to say for you, if it helps, everybody has a shadow, but not all shadows have one. Think on it. And I
will think on it.
Think about it.
But not all shadows have one.
Not all shadows have one, indeed, yes.
The only toys we had were a Rector's
set. That's exploding.
Mickey's Filet, a Rector's set.
So you are choosing, you were saying like the menagerie or the
I'm not like in the menagerie. Okay. I'm saying I'm basically just looking for a plaza or a park or whatever that sort of I would assume like you
the
have
square?
The menagerie, the garden, and that yeah, you'd have a square in the middle, you know, sort of thing.
So you're thinking like the city square? Like,
yeah, exactly.
Okay. Dead center.
Yeah.
Very good.
Ground zero.
Ground zero.
Well, now you put it that way. Thanks. Okay. That doesn't bring,
it
you know.
Fine.
You're going to teleport them all there?
Yes.
You need to roll a D100, please.
Mm-hmm. And as the teleportation is exploding up and we are starting to be warped in any capacity
yes.
when we're going.
Every atom ripped apart.
Soho will look at the empty seat
and how nice
was
yeah.
and
thank you.
Nod a lament in hopes that he is thinking that he's hoping that Melf is okay fighting Eus. And he looks at his companions as they're starting to face up. He says, together we push on. Together we will see the next dawn. To the land where science may have spawned. In hopes to right wrong. And then...
I mean, I'm just hoping that your class levels are shifting, like Paladin goes, tink, and Bard goes, yeah.
And as that happens,
just use instruments.
And hopes that
oh.
all of you three will get inspiration.
Oh, okay.
Is this the
spell?
I forget you also have an inspiration from.
I do remember.
My initial roll was 47. Right.
47.
However, Elminster has advantage. And. If I fail the saving throw, I can choose to succeed instead.
I'll tell you what. Yeah, I think we can. You start to feel. You said 40 something.
47.
I'll tell you what. That's actually enough.
Okay.
Because we're considering this a very familiar place.
Okay.
You did grow up here.
Yeah.
Even though it is very changed now, it is still the same rough terrain, rough location.
I could almost imagine like same. We appear 5 feet in the air.
Yeah. Oh, this is, no.
That's right.
Basically just going to get a clumsy entrance.
Okay.
Right.
But you are on target. So that is fine. So
this is your captain speaking. What? Sorry for the bumpy landing. It's just going to get better from
yes.
here on out.
Remember those. This inspirations last for 10 minutes.
Yep.
Hopefully we're in the middle of action here.
Yep.
No pressure.
So there is a lurch in a as around you you see the ruined remnants of architecture similar to what you saw in Shar, kind of around the Caneth Tower, but overgrown with webs of metallic vines and trees of steel bark with silver leaves and leathery tendrils kind of curling around them. There's you're in the middle of a square where you can see there is lots of dilapidation that has come down. Parts of the pathways have cracked. act and burst through with either these steel gardening type plants or just straight up destruction. Up ahead, there is a large office looking building, a sort of like a parliament like building, which has this the sigil of Caneth House, the Gorgon's face, cracked and fractured, with one half of it completely on the ground. There are statues rusted and unmaintained, and as well as others which seem to have plinths where there might have one point been statues or something on display that are strangely absent and look to have been so for quite some time. You don't get a chance to really take in too much of this surrounding, as you immediately notice that the entire place is swarming with walking dead. The main thing that you first realize is as you materialize into this place, a large shadow looms overhead and flies past you onwards as you look up to see a shadowy, purple-flamed, draconic figure soaring overhead. And for those of you who have decent perception, you can see that there appears to be an armored figure riding atop this being. And from the other end, away from it, is an entire army of various undeads, spectral, muscled, bony, on horses, being led by a figure whose head is engaged in green flames and pestilence spewing off of its form, riding forth, pointing at the figure as they continue on, and you hear it utter in its guttural, lifeless voice, "Get the card."
Okay.
Race time.
Where are they heading?
Towards the purpley shadowy draconic figure overhead. But as you appear, several of these undead do immediately kind of look over and notice you, and they raise their finger.
Solar Bastion.
And they begin to make their way towards.
What?
No.
Your friends.
You don't know, you know a guy?
Well, if they wish to join, absolutely.
However, let not the Bastion intrude. Kill him and his followers.
Well, that's quite up the exposition. Clears it up quite quickly, yes. Thank you for that. And then, so all of them are...
No, so most of the right. Riders are continuing on.
Just as a random, immediate note, seeing that there's trouble. Merrick's... starts doing some of his little usual things that you've seen that you know are his common sort of battle move here. As he does it, Stinky, who's been sitting on his shoulder this time, straightens up and actually sort of strikes a little pose with his little beard, sort of straightens out like static electricity, and he goes, "Haste!" and I do this, and it sort of flows. You see, like, a little energy, like, you know, sort of like his beard, like I said, is sort of standing on edge, and he's sort of holding this little pose. So I am casting haste and transferring it to Stinky.
As these pestilence kind of glowing undead begin to make their way over towards you, from the other side, a few other shambling mounds, well, I shouldn't use that, shambling figures make their way towards you. You kind of can see rotting faces and grimy hair, but the unmistakable suits and sigils of that of House Caneth lumbering their way and engaging with the other undead. Purple fire glaring in their eyes and radiating out every hole in their flesh.
Like fighting the undead?
Okay, yes.
Hold this up for a moment. The purple. Dragon is purple.
Mm-hmm.
This guy's green. Is that correct?
The enemy. So there's a lot of undead. Oh, is what you're getting.
Wait a minute.
There appear to be two forces.
Right.
One, which is the one that pointed out Solar Bastion getting the card, a horde of undead riding an invading force. Then there's the shadowy purple flamed dragon with the rider, and there appear to be other undead with similarly colored purple flame radiating from its eyes and outside.
So
are fighting.
How far away from these things?
It's all around you. You've just spawned into the center of this debacle.
So, okay, and how big is the room?
No, you're in like the plaza, square, the plaza of a city.
Oh,
so, and when a dilapidated, ruined city.
And when we say army coming this way, are we talking about thousands, hundreds? What are we talking?
I would say a squad.
Oh, okay.
Like a good, maybe that's not the right. No, that's not the right term.
A legion, a battalion,
larger than a platoon. Two platoons.
Okay. Yeah, a phalanx. Yeah, like a good.
Where's Melf when we need him?
Yeah, right.
Like a good size chunk of, but it's a lot of like zombies and skeletons just mismatched, and they all have this like green flamey pestilence about them. Okay. With their rider who's got the flaming skull on horseback.
You said that the purple thing flashed across his shadow fight, so it flew, was flying overhead. Where is it now?
It is circling around as you see energy surging down the fiery purple and bodies rising up from the Caniff workshops and beginning to make their way and engage with the other
forces. Yeah, I gotta say, this guy seems like absolutely a bad guy, but I don't appreciate, this is a Aston, not Karnath. So, yeah.
Do you detect any evil coming from the ones above?
Oh, I don't even.
Would you like to use divine sense?
No. But I would like to look at the undead with green in them.
Sure.
Have I seen.
Green is attacking.
Is that green? Green is attacking us, or green will attack us. Is the green reminiscent of glowing Rennick?
It doesn't have that same. No.
So they're not Vitae.
They do not appear to be that way, no.
All right. And then I will. Does any of this look any bit worldly that I would know?
None of this looks familiar to you, although you fought undead before. These are obviously undead. Are
they, what does Mabel have to say about this?
Yeah.
You want to consult the diaries?
What I'm wondering is
you could. I don't know.
No, is this a moment like where we have like they're coming and we've got like
you have
classic movie dialogue to have a moment, or do I have to blow suspend here? Like,
I think you should probably blow suspend.
Okay. Okay.
How close are they?
Wait,
got a big issue here.
There's something I want to do, but I really do need to know how close.
Ask out of character questions first. I go suspend.
Yeah. Everything is kind of all around. There are undead coming their way toward.
But how close are the closest?
They are roughly 20 feet continuing.
And are they all coming from the same?
You only seem to be being attacked by the ones with the rider. The purple flamed ones are just dealing with those other undead. So they don't seem to have any interest in you.
So it is one direction that we're worried about.
Okay, so
there is a roar in the distance as the shadowy purple flaming dragon rears up and roars, and that's when you see the Caniff undead beginning to rise.
The rider has the card.
Yes. Rider has the card.
The dragon.
Rider has the card.
I don't think you need to do this for this reason. Let's plan this other thing and.
Ready?
I don't know if you need to.
Let's do it. Do it. Do it. Do your thing.
Do your thing before I blow.
I will just stand right in front of their 20 feet away, whatever.
These are the horse riders and.
This is the undead horde that's coming towards us, and I will say, "This is how you use this," and I will hold up mine.
Symbol of Raven Kai.
And I will expend my charges to turn undead. But they all within 30 feet down from where I am, have to make wisdom saving throws at disadvantage.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to, let's see what happens.
Oh, it's me.
Selfie,
love it. We gotta get it, right? I suppose.
Oh, wizards wants it.
Wizard, okay, but sure, I was making a weird face.
Okay. Here's what's gonna happen.
Dirt face.
Did you get it?
You raise high.
And you can see it's like the sun or whatever like comes through. And like.
Can I get a ribbon cut selfie?
Yeah. Send me all these photos.
Raising it high, the undead of the sort of the hut, the riders and those that are raised, the mismatched ones.
I mean, anyone who sees it's gonna run.
I understand that. Mm-hmm. Immediately, some of them just and they begin to peel back and away, and others of them repel themselves. You see the rider look around, its head furiously blazing into kind of a purpley greenish smoke, and just insects and vile locusts fly out from underneath the folds of its robes.
Is this a Primarch?
No.
A Hivarch, excuse me.
No. But yeah. But all of the ones with the purple flames in them just kind of, and then continue on as if unaffected entirely. As the rider of the
dragon. But they're not concerning.
This is true. As the rider of the draconic entity flies its way back towards, and the creature opens its jaws, plume of purple fire spews out, coating onto the undead. The rider then turns the flaming skull again turns its attention to Inade. If you could please give me a constitution save.
The good news is you get to add +7 to it.
I also have advantage on all things.
You still got that sky staff, right?
Yeah.
I'm just saying, maybe it's time to take to the sky.
Come on. Yeah. Cool. While Inode is rolling. I get the sense after watching what happened? So these undead start to like turn and run. This guy's doing his thing.
Mm-hmm.
Do I feel like they were not attacking us and they were going to help? Like, they're obviously against each other.
They are.
But do I feel like they were going to be on our side? Because it seems like they were going to be attacking us.
Yeah, you're not getting the whole ally, you're getting the enemy of my enemy.
The green ones are going to kill him.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you went on. I thought you did the green ones.
Yeah, the green ones were repelled. The purple ones were not.
Right. So you got the bad guys. You got the ones trying to kill.
Okay.
The green ones are after him.
I got a 27.
27. A necromantic energy pours forth from the eye sockets of the empty skull as it slams into you, but you kind of hold that and flush that out of your system.
Okay. And it's almost like a time shift happens and it just doesn't affect
you. Yeah.
Oh, well, if you want to play, happy to play.
the draconic rider flies up behind a massive, and a gargantuan metal hulk, half-built, pieces of metal still starting to kind of pull and dilapidate out as it flies around and perches atop still being manufactured parts of some kind of massive colossus that's similar to the Warforged in appearance. As the dragon once again roars and the figure continues to swirl purple fire around it.
Guiding bolt? I mean, you have a proper initiative.
We don't know that he's...
He seems pretty bad.
He was feeling the flame.
Anybody have any idea about this confusion?
So, purple guy, who's got the card? Purple guy's got the card. Green guy is trying to kill Imide. Green is back against you.
Do you have any idea what they are?
Purple guy is trying to kill green guy. And green guy also wants the card.
Yes.
But I'm saying green seems to be our problem. Purple seems like we might as well not attack them until they attack us. Even though we have to get the card from them.
Didn't purple just attack?
That was green. Yeah. Purple breathed fire on the other undead. Purple attacked green, not us.
And green guy
attacked me.
And do we have any idea who this green guy is?
I have no clue.
Right, but so...
We meet many along that path.
This guy isn't from your neck of the woods, is he?
No.
Give me...
Oh no.
A history check.
Maybe.
With advantage.
With advantage.
Oh. You really must know.
Well,
Dad!
Papa?
20 plus.
Oh, a natural 20? 20. Yeah.
Natural 20.
Okay.
27.
6 feet.
The Bastani used to tell stories of a figure that once stalked the hills of Barovia, but has recently no longer been something to be worried. A being that was clad all in armor and was said to carry purple fire and called himself Lord Soth.
That's purple guy.
Yes.
Not green guy.
That's right.
Okay.
And was he I'm just saying, what was this Sith guy like? He was
a Death Knight. He had betrayed...
Sith.
He betrayed...
Sith Lord.
He was seduced by the dark side. He essentially went back on his oath committed sin right at the point that the gods were effectively done with his world, and so was punished eternally to walk as an undead being, forever mired in the weight of his guilt. The only reason he got out of, he's one of the only known Dark Lords to have escaped Ravenloft, and the only reason supposedly that the Vistani tell is that the powers that be got bored of torturing him because he just took it in stride and did
he didn't really care.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, he was feeding off of it, and basically, it was not even torture anymore. And they're the whole point of the whole point of the dark powers that are like that. They want to torture you.
It is so disturbing when you're a dark power, you have a great plan to torture, you bring the person in, and then you're like, oh, he likes it.
As for the other undead, I won't give you as much information, but
he had his 20s.
I know. But there is something that does occur to you that occasionally in your travels and your association with cards, you have interacted with others who have used the deck of many things or have at least come across it, and one of the things that they always tell you is that it is a powerful artifact, and there are orders across the multiverse that very much desire or seek or interact with the different cards. The one that is generally feared upon and would likely be known to someone of Ravenloft is what's called the Grim Harrow. And the Grim Harrow are those that are attracted to the card of the skull. And whenever it is pulled, whenever the skull card is said to be drawn, I mean, it generally leads to the death of those who have drawn the card. And it is said that the souls of those that card has killed are forever bound to walk the multiverse as horrible undead beings, never to truly find an end to their existence, forced to relive over and over again their own deaths. And as such, they seek the destruction of all cards, so they can end their horror.
Like, cards from the deck of many things are just cards in general. They're just like kind of jackasses, Pokemon, you know.
Collect them all.
No, I
got it. So I got like 30 seconds on this. Do you want to go back in?
Or one thing. Yeah. They seem to know the solar vast.
They certainly do.
I'm assuming, is there any chance in my training or in our vast knowledge.
Why don't you give me a history check?
With advantage.
Yeah.
Okay, good. That'll need it.
13. Not bad.
13 it is. plus history. Donde estas? Where, there it is. That is a 14.
A 14. there is mention of the Grim Harrow that you received in your training. It was more so like the fact that they were in opposition to everything your order stood for and would often get involved in the various things, clashes.
Okay.
But you personally have never encountered or faced them at all on Imaria.
Got it. So as soon as...
Ready? So 30 seconds left?
As that starts happening, I reach out and I tap on the Book of Exalted Deeds.
Mm-hmm.
And you tell me if I can still do this, but you see a halo appear on the top of his head.
Halo?
A halo. Literal.
Master Chief?
Get a soul rifle and set. Let's go. And it starts, it spreads light almost 10 feet in all directions in front. And you see any undead that starts in that circle get affected.
Yeah, they're going to have some problems with that. So
that will happen in just a second.
Right.
So we're still frozen in time. We have about 30 seconds left to talk.
We will kill.
Does anyone know what this last thing he said before all that?
Right. So I explain Lord Toth, and I say we need to kill him first.
Explain it. 30 seconds.
I just did.
Do we need to kill him? He's got the card. Can we chat with the guy? He hasn't attacked us yet.
No. We kill the green guy.
Oh, green guy.
Yes.
Can I go chat with Sith while we...
We get Soth.
Yeah, you keep Sith busy.
Yeah, you keep Sith busy while we get
Soth. We'll pick up your body afterwards.
Sure.
Yeah. Right, I guess that this.
I think it's yeah.
Oh no, okay. No, we're not killing Zoth. You keep Zoth busy. Sorry. Yeah. And we kill.
Kill Greeny.
Green.
I believe in you.
Hello.
And with that, we will roll initiative.
Okay. Make it do it.
Okay, so everyone is around me, so everyone gets the benefits. I rolled a 12 for Elise, you get plus 7 to that.
A 19.
14 to Merrick's, plus 7 to that.
That is 23.
3 to Elminster, I apologize, but plus 7 to that.
Hmm. 7, 14.
And a day 2, I'm sorry. And I got a 7 for me.
Oh, yeah. So 14 for me, total.
And I get a dirty 20. Oh, he's so sorry. Oh.
Okay.
Look at this map.
So, Inoday can. With mine. So he should be the 14 ahead of my 14.
I assume. That's how I set it up. Yeah.
But what does he do again? What does he do with time?
I can. That's the sound. Dial tone.
It'll do.
Oh God, I don't want to be done.
So in a day, the rider's green flame surges into a hollow void, just black bruise-colored energy. As blue frost courses up from their bottom and black darkness courses down from their top, and the fabric of space rips open in front of you, and I need you to make a constitution saving throw.
What
are you just going into the abyss again? Is this like what we do now?
You will get plus 7 from there.
Yeah.
My aura protects you, my friend.
Yay! Out of curiosity, what kind of attack is this?
A hollow void.
Well, fear-based?
No.
Don't skip things.
Yeah, I was just asking, is it charm or fear?
It's stun.
Stun, okay. Oh,
God.
Stun the monk?
No.
God damn it. Do you get advantage at all, or...?
On stun attacks, no. I get advantage on all,
Constitution saves?
Yeah, all saves.
Well, there you go.
The monks. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. My God. That's part of my level 20 monk.
Well, that's level 20 for you.
Yeah, well, yeah, I mean, you know.
9 plus...
Remember, plus 7 from Tommy.
Yeah, 9 plus 8, 17, plus 24.
Oh. You take half of 49 force damage.
Okay, so 20...
Round down.
Okay.
24.
As you feel that of nothingness assault your form, parts of your skin just kind of peels back ever so slightly. Your hair kind of falls out a little bit, and the leather of your small amounts of wear does crack and rot. Then the horse rider. Where is Inaday there? You are.
He's in the middle.
He's got to get through Elise.
Oh, he's got to get through Elise.
Who's
or try? Who's yeah? And she's got the she's got her
saving throw. Succeeded on the saving throw. Okay, I just wanted to make sure because
yeah, the three of these guys did. Then yeah, he will barrel forth in his horse, or they will barrel. It's hard to tell. Looks like a woman.
Barely. You know, it'll barrel forth.
What's his reach? Their reach.
5 feet. So
okay. So
she will strip. Or she will just step. Yeah, the horse. Her and the horse will just step forward into nothing.
Mm. Oh.
And then reappear directly next to Inaday, sword coming down directly on
there
top of you.
There goes my plan.
From invisibility, making this an advantage attack. Cool. That's a 15, 16 to hit.
Nope.
Yeah. It was a 1 and a 2.
Me!
You're at backswing! That's better. A backswing coming in at 33.
Yikes! Wow!
Right, 13 slashing damage as the sword cuts it into you, plus 33 cold damage.
Holy cow!
As the ice along the blades crushes itself into you.
33 plus 13?
That's right.
Okay.
46. Don't forget, friends, you still have my spell casting speed up.
Yo, don't worry. We got plans.
The rider with the purple cloak.
Mr. Dungeon Master, we have a question.
I'm sorry. I forgot one thing about my turn undead.
Okay.
All of the creatures that are not these dudes.
Yes.
I'm assuming they're pretty low level.
They are.
they actually die.
Destroyer. Yeah, a lot of them are being disintegrated.
Okay, I just want
to. So for sure, I assumed you had destroyer at this point. but the knight, the undead knight on Merrick's and Elminster's side there.
Mm-hmm.
That one?
Yes, the one. No, the other one.
Oh.
One on the other side.
Closest to
closer
it.
Black to you. One. Yeah, that one. That guy. That one is going to surround themselves in an aura of deadly white insects.
Ew.
And it is
really
going to...
I think I better fly.
ooh. Interesting. Okay. They are going to... It is going to... Unable to get to in a day, it is going to outstretch its weapon and fire off a spell as it begins to chant.
There's some marketing going on here because this is Beatles and Grimm.
One thing I forgot. I'm still learning. Sorry about this. I'm still learning the time dilation monk features. I have something called rapid reprisal.
Yes.
It says that because of my speed and reaction time are unparalleled, when a creature within 5 feet of me. Hits you with a melee attack,
which it did.
I can use my reaction to make an opportunity attack against that creature with an unarmed strike or monk weapon.
Would you like?
Hell yeah!
Hell fucking yeah!
Yes, absolutely.
I will also say that the aura, the halo around your head, is like.
Wait, yeah, you should have disadvantage.
Oh yeah,
on the second one too.
Oh yeah,
you did.
Well, it counteracted because they were invisible, so the first roll was. Yeah.
Okay. All right.
The
Sure. If that's how the rules work.
Counter. Yeah.
Would have advantage. He's probably allowed one or two since we wiped out a ledge.
Yeah.
Admittedly,
The halo is surging around, keeping kind of a blinding light on this creature as the. This, however, is Go ahead, and make your attack.
Allow me a retort, and then I'm going to do a stunning strike.
Okay.
9 plus, I think, what is that? Stunning strike, 9 plus 10, 19 to hit.
19 to hit?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, that'll hit.
Hell yeah. I will do stunning strike. Where's my stunning strike? Should be here. Attacks. Single attacks. There we go. Huh. Why does it not show stunning strike? That's part of my thing. I thought that's like a basic
ability.
Yeah, I think it has to make a con save or something.
Yeah, if you want to try to stun it.
Yeah. Do I not have it as part of my
stunning strike is a thing all monks get.
That's what I thought, but it's not in my. Oh, there it is. Yeah. When you hit a creature with melee weapon attack, you can spend one key point to attempt stunning strike.
Okay,
and you need to make a constitution save.
Right, you slam into it in the stunning point, then there's no effect.
Because I'm dead.
Yeah, we all know the sound of a key point being spent, though, right?
Yeah.
There we go.
It's a penny into a cup.
Yeah. And all that. All right.
Assuming you have
now we're cooking there. Gas.
Yeah, so then I will also... So with my damage is 1d10
plus... I like this.
D10.
Crunch.
I'm just saying, without Melfior, someone's sexy points going.
Okay. So what do we see as the as this creature comes up with its blade of frost and gets you inside with it?
I like block it with my arm, and you see him wince, especially with ice.
Yeah, just ice form crystal
on the hand. Like one hand is like deteriorating slightly, the other hand is now forming ice. And there's a moment of wincing. And then again, a serene face, and he goes, allow me to retort a little. And I go up there and honestly just go up and flick him on the nose. Look at that.
The little skull nose is.
Yes.
Die, Bastion.
Oh, well, I would if I could, but I can't, so no.
Okay. Now, where were the. Right, yes. Spell being cast by one of them.
Right. Which one?
The that one there, it's beginning to chant the arcane sigils of a spell, the incantations.
Can we take that?
I can react now.
Counterspell.
Yes. Sure. Okay. What level would you like to cast counterspell at?
Fifth.
Good choice.
Okay. The spell is channeling off. You just go. And you grab the cloud kill and just throw it away.
Hey, nicely done, Mystara.
Okay. I'll throw it good. Over there on top of those dinosaurs.
Yeah. It seems quite furious. As the champion directly in front of Inade brings a burst of crushing force down upon you. Please make a strength save.
Which one?
The one in front of Inade.
This one?
No, the one in front of Inade.
That one.
Yes.
Oh, it's making
you got again?
Yes.
Legendary action.
Oh, legendary action.
Oh, fun times.
On whom?
Inade.
You do get plus 7 to this.
Okay.
Strength saving?
Strength save.
You got actually, I think I have something for my strength save thing. Hold on.
And then it'll be Merrick's.
Oh, hold on. I get an additional force and all.
While he's looking it up.
Sorry. No, I don't have that.
He kicks some ass.
Oh, well, yeah, I got plans.
I think also the one that was casting the spell will move up.
How far?
To get up to where to we within range of both Elise and Inade.
Okay, right there.
Okay, no matter. As the insects begin to pour themselves out.
Oh, from that spell. Okay, I was thinking.
Thank you. Strength is saving throw. 8.
That beat the roll again.
13. Oh, I got an advantage. That's right.
That advantage is going to save your life, monk.
Yeah.
There we go. 19 plus 7. No.
26.
Okay. You just take the force and disperse it throughout your body.
Well, I was like, man, those wrists are strong.
You too can get them.
You just start banging a bottle.
As you make your way to Merrick's, are you within 10 feet of that knight that just moved up?
I am technically.
Then you need to make a constitution save as the insects begin to bite and sting and swarm around.
I got you, kid.
You know what I say? Hold my mead. all right, that is a 32. Yeah. I mean, I'm wearing, environmentally controlled.
It's his Fjellin's cologne that he's got.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, so I'm glancing at Lil'el.
Something I do want to also say, though, is I do need Elminster to make a constitution save.
All right.
To channel the energy of magic in the Mornlands.
All right.
Ah.
But I'm going to have to do that, too.
Ooh. You get to add 7 to it, though.
But plus 7.
Damn,
and, oh, he gets plus 5 on top of that. So, 15. 50.
No, you got better than that. I see a plus 12 constitution saving throw over there, plus you roll the 3, so that's 15 plus 7 is 22.
22.
You know, I mean, not to...
That is enough. You feel a little bit of a strain to cast your counterspell, but it does indeed not affect you. But anyway, Commander Merrick's.
I'm about to cast a spell myself, so we'll see how that goes. As I said, I got a little stinky on my shoulder, and I'm like, you got this? And I am using my die to, as a bonus action, cast skill empowerment.
Okay.
So I'm just pulling out a thing and going and taking a little like shot of some little alchemical thing I have.
So casting a spell will require a constitution.
Yes. And again, that time it's 40.
Okay.
I think I'm doing okay.
Paladins!
And I'm skill empowering persuasion, just so I have that going on. And then I am zipping up on being hasted. I can go 100 squares, and I'm just trying to get up to
as you approach the figure, the armored figure atop the dragon, the shadow and flame.
There we are.
Two red eyes glare at you from beneath plated dark armor.
Hi, honey, I'm
home. As the purple flame continues to surge around the entire being, as it just turns its head to look over at you.
Well, let's just for a start.
You wear the mark of this place.
I do. For a start, just before we have a quick chat, just as a casual 20 insight, like, what am I getting his vibe as?
He looks like he's not a very nice person.
Understood.
But he also looks like he doesn't like the position he's been put into.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's basically, we've got this fight going on. Does it feel like he wants a fight?
No.
Or is he doesn't have a choice about this?
You're feeling is that he has likely been trying to keep these things away from him for some time now. And it's just been a constant endless undead, and he's very much done
with. So we're gonna surprise everybody because I'm actually gonna use his proper name here, because this is business. And so I am, you know, and it will not surprise me if it is going to take more than one round for us to have an ongoing conversation. That is fine. So, but just starting up, I am just approaching him and saying, Lord Soth, like Baron Merix of Hell's Kenneth, your deeds are legendary. And as is your suffering, I have come here to try and make a deal. This arrangement obviously isn't very good for you. You have something I need. I might have something you could use.
Okay. We will hold until Soth's turn for his rebuttal.
Which is now.
Do you want a casual persuasion on that, by the way?
Yes,
or do you want
to wait till it comes
a single roll situation, but.
Rebuttal? Rebuttal, not response?
What does skill power might give you?
Okay.
It gives me expertise.
Nice.
So it just makes me a little better. I'll hold that. Yeah, it's a 29. It's I'm like, it could be better, but it's still not bad.
Oh, but inspiration?
Oh, I'm just saying, I think a 29 is, this is not going to be the only one we have. I think a 29 is a good, yeah.
We'll hold on a bad day.
We're on 23 for Merrick's right now.
Just because, we're at rest at some point. I do have a flash of genius, and you know, and I am just like I said. I'm trying to sort of do a combination of showing him respect, but I am gonna like flex some magic, you know, around like he gets the idea that I have some power. You know what I'm saying? So I'm someone to be listened to. So anyhow, that means all in all, a 35 on my persuasion.
The Death Knight, or the Grim Champion that had just made its way into close proximity with the party, again rushes waves of necrotic energy at Inaday.
Mm.
They really don't like you.
Apparently,
you're gonna need to make a Constitution save.
No way.
If you want less than held, that works.
Then you'll need to make a strength save as the one on the horse again just comes down on you.
Both constitution and strength save?
Yes, right.
Okay. Well, by the way, one thing I forgot to mention is it's not an automatic advantage. I'm spending key points.
Understood.
Yeah.
He's making saves. He's not being attacked.
That's right. These are saves. These ones are saves.
Okay.
And don't forget your monkey advantage.
Yeah. That's a 10. That's a 12. It should be fine.
Yeah, you get plus 7. I think it should be 27 or something like that.
Yeah, and 8 since I'll... Yeah, so 10 plus... what was the first one?
Constitution.
So 18 plus 7. So 25 for Constitution.
Yep.
And
that's 12 strength.
Plus 7. Strength is also, I think, 8. Yeah. So 8 to 22, 27 for strength.
Okay. Both you're able to withstand.
Mm-hmm.
As the last one... The other Grim Champion there, yep, is going to outstretch its black and orange and red, yellow fire will surge up through its bones and out the armor that it wears as spectral blades will begin to swarm around it and energize themselves right in the midst of all of you in a 20-foot cube.
Okay. What a jerk. 20-foot cube is a 4, so yeah, I can get
all of you essentially. Yeah. I need everyone to make a dexterity save who isn't Merix.
Is this a blade barrier?
This is just an innate thing they can do.
Okay.
26. Mm-hmm. Plus 7, friends. Plus 7.
23.
So long as I stand here, none of you will fall.
17.
Nice.
Dexterity.
You're like in the 30 zone now.
Yeah.
It's 27 plus 34.
34, okay.
26.
26.
23.
And yours was crazy, I think.
Right? 24.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. 26. So you will all take half of 27 slashing.
And I will take none. Because I have evasion.
Very good.
That's right.
Yeah.
You gotta show us how to do that.
Yeah. I'm too impressed.
Sorry, half of how much?
Half of 27.
We're essentially taking time, young acolyte. You will find the way.
Okay.
It's going to use all 40 of its feet to
move. I'm sorry. I will. I. That's an attack. So I will. Who's right next to me?
Death Knight or
no? Yeah.
He doesn't take any damage anyway, so don't.
He didn't take any.
Nope. He got a vision. You're fine.
So that Grim Champion will use all 40 of its feet to circle around behind and get to the other, no, like around the other way with its fellows, kind of come around the other side of
where Elminster is,
right in front of Elminster, and in a day.
There's no space.
There's no space.
Like right in front of Elminster.
Like there or there.
Further towards you.
Toward the side. Right next to his dude.
There. Right there. Yeah, the right there.
Oh, I see bodyguards. Okay.
Yep. And he's going to attack in a day from there, I think.
Okay.
How does he get 40 feet?
Yeah, that he wouldn't be able to do.
Going around.
Yeah. He can go around. He can go through his enemies.
Yeah, going through his allies.
Okay, so the deal is that the horseman is a 10-foot square.
Got it. Okay.
And there's only 3 squares that can attack in a day, and we already got one. Unless it's got reach.
Then the other option is going to be it's going to come up next to between Loholt and and Elise.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
That way, they can hit in a day.
And technically, a flanking.
If they swing a blazing morning star 3 times with advantage, knocking out.
You can block that.
With your disadvantage, knocking out its advantage, giving it a straight roll.
You're doing it to in a day?
That's right.
Okay.
So there's a blazing morning star comes crashing down towards in a day. Crush the bastion. Mm-hmm. It's going to be.
Wait for my turn.
A 31.
You didn't mention all this.
You are going to take a little less than 31.
No, that's the hit. The damage is coming.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's looking at 10 piercing and 14 fire.
So 24 total.
Mm-hmm. Okay, except
you got a
reaction. I am going to. I have too much stuff that I can do. I am going to intercept, is what it's called, and as soon as I find out, I believe
it's... Is the superior already died to reduce the damage?
It's fighting style. It's not a superior.
Oh, nice.
It's in this list, and I'm intercepting it, and I believe it's a deep
end. Well, you can go on with the attacks, because it'll just reduce damage, but I mean, it's not like...
Next attack is going to be a...
I'll keep track.
27 hits. Okay. So another 10 piercing and 14 fire. And then the last attack is a 14 to hit, which I believe will miss.
So the first two is 24 plus, what was the other amount?
Okay.
I got 48
plus damage. Your bonus.
48 to reduce it first, and we'll see how much you take. And then get out of dodge. Right.
Then I'll need you to make a strength save from the crush.
Yep.
13, it goes away.
13 of it goes away, so 35 you're taking it all. Okay.
Thank you. No worries. 14
strength, you said? Mm-hmm. 14 plus 8 is 22 plus 7.
29.
Okay. You are not crushed by the force, though one of the champions does bring their staff down towards you for a 27 to hit.
It hits.
Okay, 8 bludgeoning and 21 necrotic. Is it?
Still up, huh?
Yeah, 8 bludgeoning plus 21.
That's right.
So 29 total. So that is a 51.
Yeah. Is that what you left?
That's what I got.
All right, we got you.
And you see at this point, Inode is like, his clothes seem grimy. He's like, whew, they really don't like me.
At initiative count 20, the undead either are all beginning to be pushed back as the skeletons burst into ash, the zombies begin to melt away, and several of them just about face and flee from the energy projecting out of Elise's symbol of Ravenkind. Merix.
Yes.
Lord Soth turns his head to address you. What are you proposing? I see there is allyship to have here. You are native to this realm.
Well, we got a couple options. First off, you know, I want the card. That's pretty straightforward, obvious.
You seek this.
That's what I seek. So, we got two options. The first is I can find a place for you here. I know a guy, I know a gal, I think you and Lady Elmero could be a match made in heaven. She's an ally.
I seek only to reclaim my knightland.
Okay, so this is the point. You want to go back where you can't just relatively recently came from. I know a gal who can get you there. So we can get you back to a certain misty place if That's what you're looking for. You give me the card.
Hello.
I'll get you back.
I wish to return to Nightland and reclaim it so that it may be known as Nightland.
With a K. I understand. With, you know, Knightland.
Yes.
As I said.
No, legit.
I gave him my word as a baron. You give me the card. We'll get you. I don't want to say it's home because I don't think it is, but it's, you know, home to is Krynn. Where you want to crush your enemies.
He wants to get the Krynn.
We'll make it happen.
But I will crush those who have taken my land.
Well, you know, what happens once you get there? That is that we make no promises on. We're just
death against those who dare claim themselves lord of my domain.
As I say, what happens when you get there? I'm not saying like we aren't gonna stop him once he's there. I'm just saying we'll take him there. After that,
knows where
you know,
the cards there will be.
Exactly. Wait,
ask him if he can be our guide when we go.
Oh my god!
All right, so I'm still putting
so
out there.
Now, Lohol.
We'll transport.
Yes.
So that'll be Soth's turn. So yep. Lohol.
So the guy that's just pounding away at it today.
Yes.
I think Inadin needs to get out of there. So I'm gonna carve a path. So I'm gonna turn. I'm just gonna like turn, and as I'm turning, like. A cog of time spins, and I just bonus action celerity speed up, take my blade, casually helicopter, and then crush that knight. This one right here.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And I say good night.
The one that's on fire
with a K, whichever one is hitting there. 26 to hit.
That's a hit. Go through the plate.
All right. Way higher than a 26 to hit. And then another 26 to hit. So all three are connecting.
Very good.
I am dropping a level 4 smite on the first one.
Okay. These are undead.
Yep. Mm-hmm. I will need some D8s, my friends.
And they all have, they're all within my halo, so they all have disadvantage.
That's right.
So Avengers, D8s.
Oh, and here's this too.
So I'll get an additional D8, correct?
Do you need that's right.
Okay. So first hit. He is taking 12. 14, 16, 22 radiant, and 15 Ember Fang.
Okay.
Second hit, another fourth level smite. He is taking 20 Ember Fang and 10, 22 radiant again. And I must reduce one die, and I will drop a third level smite on the third hit.
Just why not, right?
Yeah. And in addition to that, what the hell? Let's wrathful smite him. Then he has to leave if he's still alive. All my spell points. Oh, gross! 20 Amber Fang and 10, 25, 28, 29, 30 radiant. Leave him alone!
So half of this champion is just blasted away. Shards of flaming plate steel fly off. The flames around the skull begin to dim out. It's more of just some light smoke as you wail into them. The head kind of turns towards the rider. The rider kind of turns towards them. Please make a wisdom save.
He has to make a wisdom save. Or be feared.
Immune to fear.
My wisdom save, 28.
You feel a compelling urge to stab Inadin in the back, but you resist it.
I look at him and go, no, you're next. Is this a dead knight still alive?
Oh yeah, but very, very.
No, never. I mean, they haven't been alive for a long
time. Yeah.
Yes.
I'm gonna play my fife if you keep it up. But
yes. So, you see Elise draw a card.
Big spells.
And she spins the card out in a circle. It's not going to unfortunately hit the other guy, but from right here, covering these two only, but centered here, silence.
Okay.
As she burns this for that bonus. And then she will, flip out a card and let it go into flames, burning that for spirit guardians.
Okay.
At 9.
Okay.
Holy.
Give me those D8s. For later when they get
there. So I'm just going to flare up when you do
that. You see the light like flicker a little bit as she like does it. And you see, you hear it first.
Hello.
And as they start to crawl around, which will cover everybody.
Yeah.
And then, I mean, it doesn't hit until the beginning of their turns, but then...
Diamond dogs.
Then, she will actually take her action. and start smacking the hell out of... these guys, and she's gonna hit the guy on the horse first because why not?
Mm-hmm.
Actually, you know what? Maybe she action surges. Oh no, she can't because it's a spell. She did the sped up spell for silence. Okay, it's fine. Smack with my brand new
flame top.
You say the
words?
I say hello, hot stuff. I go to smack him the first time.
Whoa!
With a natural 12!
Wow.
Okay.
Hey, but now you gotta deal with the rest of us.
You want me to full in the plus what I roll? Is that how you do it? I can't remember.
So do you
roll, it's been so long since I've crit.
You roll double the amount of dice. You add it all together.
Okay, so not max.
Okay. No, rolling dice is fun.
Fire.
Yeah, I know. This is a good thing. So, so it's... Oh my god. So 6, 8 first, 6 of which is...
You re-roll the... Oh yeah.
So, hold on. And then another... So 6, 16, 20... 24 in my first hit.
Okay.
Does fire matter?
Fire seems to harm it just as well as your axe does.
Right, but we don't need to separate
the damage.
Right, no need to separate.
That's what I need to know. Okay, so that's the first smack. And then again, whoop-boom!
The radiant did more damage to it, though.
And it misses. No. Actually, no. I'm using my advantage.
Okay.
That you had given me from my reading.
Probably really creepy raisin. Reading. That
yeah.
Surprising.
Okay, 31 hits, I assume?
Yes.
I need more dice. This is crazy.
Okay, all right. Want those for fire?
It doesn't matter. I just need this and then this. Oh, okay. Because I'm not rolling double, sorry.
Yeah.
Not this time. Yeah, I'll do it for fire. So that time is 17 more points of damage.
Okay.
Third swing.
Come on, natural 20.
Not this time, sadly. You keep cursing me when you say that. 70?
That will bounce off of the armor.
Okay. Yeah, anyway, they can't do...
However, there is also your holy energy surrounding them at a very high power.
Oh, I do know that. It happens when they start.
Yes, I understand.
How many D8s are there?
However, it is still now there, and they can see that it is happening and manifesting.
Yeah, there's silence on them, though.
Yeah, there is. Yep. Oh, yeah, they're having a bad time. You know, Dave, if you could please...
Oh, I know what I can do with my action surge. I'm sorry, I'm going to do this.
Okay.
No, you have an action surge?
I have an action surge.
Isn't it a bonus action to do that?
No.
It's just free? Action surges. Yeah. It's only
action
once.
Thing you can
only
do.
Once.
That's amazing.
It's only once, but yeah, I'm doing it. I'm expending 3 more charges.
Why be a fighter instead of a paladin?
Make your wisdom saves again at disadvantage for all 3 of them. Boom, boom, boom!
Oh, for turn undead.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they just succeed.
Legendary resistance.
I burned it. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Well, I was gonna say. So, you know, Dave, if you could please give me a wisdom save.
Okay.
Passed. Okay. You feel an incredible, violent anger towards Elise, but then you're like,
it's just, one of those things. Like, it's a distant anger that seems to come through, and I just like, oh, passing
by. Yeah, just watch it.
They can do that without speaking?
Yeah. They can. There's a lot of things I can't do, though. As we reach Elminster's turn.
No. Would it be mine?
No. Oh, sorry. That's in a day's turn. Yeah.
This is where in a day gets it.
Reach in a day's turn. If you were to look up towards Soth, you can see this engage where the card has been removed and is in the gauntleted hands of Soth as Merix is kind of just negotiating.
I'm just,
and you can see that these undead seem to be less keen on killing you as they were previously, now that you've shown that your bodyguards or your new recruits.
Friends. Oh, yeah, new recruits.
Of the order they seem to despise are fighting back. What would you like to do?
You see him physically worn out and physically there, but you just see him like shake his head and kind of stand in a very austere manner and goes,
yeah,
well, that was fun, but I think it's about to be my turn. And he gets into a stance, and I'm going to go into my time dilation stance. Mm-hmm. And as soon as he does that, you see him shimmer, and almost immediately it looks like it blurs, and the next thing you know, you see him pop up here, pop up here, pop up here, pop up here, and just seem to like surround him in multiple spots. Each time, almost, like each one in a different pose, different stance, just smiling and going, hi, I'm here, hello, hi, I'm here, hello. And so essentially I used my everywhere at once feat. And by doing so, and then all of them look at you, who goes, your next turn should probably hit him more and point out the Death Knight specifically.
Mm-hmm.
And now you have advantage on him.
Yes, because you're everywhere at once.
Mm-hmm.
Very distracted.
So he's very distracted. So that will be my bonus action.
I love it.
That'll be my bonus action. And then as these various images are projected, I will then also use my, where is it? My empty body, and essentially go invisible.
Mm-hmm.
On my first action. On my second action, I'm going to use a key point. So each one of these were actually, let me double check and make sure I have all the key points properly tracked. So that is key point for, how many key points was it for? Going into one key point for going into stance. No key points needed to go everywhere at once.
Correct.
And then one key point to become empty body. Four. So five there. So I have enough.
Oh, wow, you got a lot.
Well, yeah, so I have eight. Still 10 total. And then on my first, that was my first action. My second action, I'm going to go ahead and do flurry of blows.
Okay.
So
on which one are you targeting?
Well, obviously my friend, who's been very, very interested in me.
Yes, the big one, the one on the
first.
Do you get advantage on this too?
He has disadvantages on all of his.
Yeah, you have an advantage, I think, though, because of everywhere all at once.
Yeah. And double check.
Or is it just other people?
Other people. While you are in there, you can grant advantage on melee attacks against creatures within 15 feet of you to one creature of your choice.
Yeah. Oh, good. So it is. Advantage.
Yeah. So you have advantage.
I have advantage.
I can change it if I want to.
I mean, you could choose yourself.
Yeah, choose yourself. You get the victory.
Okay, all right.
Kick his butt.
But you have advantage on all things.
Okay.
Hopefully between you and the whatever our minister does. This guy.
I just want to let you know, I think I got the situation under control.
Yeah.
So
we're still gonna beat this guy up just because it's personal.
Oh, why? No. I was just want to get your next. I got a plan here.
Because you get the card doesn't mean these guys are gonna go away. They want the card.
Oh, why? Well, understand.
12.
No, I'm just mean up here. Don't worry about
12.
It.
12.
No. Hold up. Actions. There it is. Flurry blows 12. 22 to hit.
Yes.
Okay.
So that's, you do hit.
I do hit.
How many attacks do you get?
So that's one attack, the first attack. So 1d10 plus 4. Cannot do stunning strike. D10. Where's my d10? Oh, there it is. 7 points of damage. And then I have the ability to do another attack.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Flurry Blows gives you an extra attack anyway, doesn't it?
Flurry Blows gives you two more.
Yeah.
Two more. Yeah, there we go then. Two more to hit.
Yeah. Get those crits.
Ooh. 19 plus 10, 20, 29 to hit.
Yeah.
And then I guess I'll do one more for the other. 25 to hit.
Yep.
All right.
All right. So that is better. 9 plus, is that a 6 or a 9?
9.
Nine? Okay, 9 plus, so 13 on the second, flurry of blows, another 7,
on the third flurry of blows, and I'll use another action. I also have action charge. Action surge.
My god.
Yay! Joy! and so I will do another flurry of blows.
Okay, we'll see
how. Oof. I have advantage, so.
With the other.
God damn it.
That'll miss. It's a four attack.
Yeah, so. Sorry.
You'll have one more attack.
One more attack, so. No, so I have advantage on each of my attempts.
Yeah. That's right.
So I still have two more attempts. Yeah. You're right. That is 20 to hit?
Yes.
Okay. And then. Ooh. That was a. I'll do again. That was a cocked. So. Oops, good. 16. That will hit. But I do want to see if I can get a 20. Both those will hit.
Krish, I want. Fit Krish. Do it. Fit Krish. Krish. Holy cow.
Are you wearing a chain of shoes?
I feel like
it. Nope, that was not a 20.
One more chance.
Come on, give me. Nope. All right, so both hit. All right. And then now to attack. Nice. 12 damage and then another 12.
All right.
You see almost all of them. Like, you see both blows you do see from all of my area at once, like all these images mm-hmm. around. It's also random images, you just do not see where it's coming from. It just seems invisibly hitting you.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yo. Now Elminster.
Right. So, the Spirit Guardians.
They're everywhere, all around you.
Yeah.
They're going to go off on the very beginning of their
journey. Yeah, they are. It's going
to
start.
Oh, here's the thing. I'm using the pipe to slowly...
Rise. Okay.
Silver fire. Line bolt.
Just get those two guys there.
The two big guys together. That's why I was asking where the spirit guardians are.
Ah, yes.
Okay. Oh, you can't hit them. They're spirits.
Good. And 10d8 radiant damage on a failed save.
Okay.
Both of them.
Nice. They are both going to succeed, so I think they'll take half the damage.
Okay, so they take the 22 each.
Okay.
But then since it's radiant, they're probably
wrong. Well. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
22, okay. Anything else?
Yes. So, Master Magic, bonus action.
Yes.
Call to mind an 8th level fireball, but use spell secrets to change the fire damage to radiant.
Okay, and just throw that at the two there.
Yeah, the two big guys, 13d6 damage.
And again, if there's any skeletons that haven't been vaporized,
and it will be at this point. Yeah. They are going to succeed.
Legendary.
But
13d6.
What average? On average?
Yeah,
a 3.5. So 39. 45.
About 45. So 45 radiant, which would be half.
22.
22.
And then, dude, I'm rolling mine.
It's almost like that's your
damage. I am rolling mine.
You gotta roll yours?
Yeah, give me all those
dice. Four. I got four.
Yeah. As we come back around to the skeletal rider's turn, they're gonna be right there in the spirit kind of guard.
48.
Yeah, I was doing D6s. Oh no, you did do C6. Yes. Never mind. We were right.
Roll it up, spirit guardians.
Is it their turn?
Yeah, they did succeed, but that's going to be the last of those.
May I borrow a...
Just roll and roll again.
Okay, fine.
You want one?
No, it's okay.
Oh, can I...
Yep.
No, I'll keep it for now.
Keep it.
Oh, yeah, right.
15, 16.
What's that?
16 to burn.
The wolves are...
25.
So what do we see? The wolves are going in and out of it?
29? Is that it? That sounds so below. 29 radiant.
How many dice was it?
9.
Oh, okay.
That's low. What's the average on that?
I mean, the average 70. On that is...
No, that's right.
I mean, it is also like every turn.
I mean, it's low, so. But it is within the scope of possibility.
Radiant.
Yep.
On both of them.
29.
The guy that I smoked has got to be dead.
All three of them.
Over dead. They all take.
Sorry, all three of them. It's my spirit guardians. Yeah.
Yep.
So the other dude.
So as these wolves just wound around, chewing and ripping and snarling at these creatures, the silver fire races across them. The one on the horse, though its face is just a skull surrounded in void, you can see based on the way the void of its skull is radiating in abject fury that it is incredibly upset. But it will raise its skeletal hand. Retreat to the gardens of decay.
We can't hear you.
Yeah, you're silent. Telepathically.
Okay, yeah.
And
oh my God, what is that you say?
And we all just
what?
And he sees this.
A gate will just open up where you can see land of pestilence and a bog of mired with blood and a tower of darkness. As the those undead fleeing from your...
Are we from the Dark Tower world? No, that was the thing.
Turn undead.
I'll have three bottles.
begin to flood into it.
That last knight that has to get through us to leave. Is he like crumbling?
Disengage. All disengage. Yeah, that knight that you wailed on is mostly just skeletal, like lingering smoke. But they all disengage and begin to retreat their way through the gates.
It doesn't matter. We're just taking time.
Yeah.
I chase them in there and kill them anyway. No.
As Merrick's.
So I got one.
Yes, you
one thing.
Solve.
I say there is one problem I just thought of that might be a thing. Hold that card up. I am hasted still, so I am casting spell. Skill empowerment again, shifting it to sleight of hand. And I'm just gonna grab that card from him.
Okay. Go ahead and give me a roll.
Jesus. We had it negotiated.
I know.
Take a while.
But it's gonna be a great moment if it works.
We have a working theory.
Word of death.
Yeah, we got a great moment if this works. And if it doesn't, then I'll be sad. But, So we are talking about, hang on just a second, because I skill empower.
Oh, wow, did you roll double?
Double 17s.
Hell!
I got, and I've got like a magic item on this. I mean, I have so many things going on. So that is 19 plus 17. That's a 36 sleight of hand. Oh, and I'm making it a 42 with another flash of genius. Does he vanish?
As you snatch the card, a purple fire surges around him. He glares at you, reaches out with one hand as a skull begins to manifest, and...
Yes, and basically... So how this,
say die.
How this works, just to say, is I say, oh, there's one problem I just thought of. You're not going to be here.
Do you have any idea what you've avoided with that? Oh my God. Die.
Like, if we take him, we think he's going to disappear anyway.
Exactly. Shit. You know, well, why make a horrible deal when we don't?
We're talking about building rivals, and I think you made a good one.
I mean, you know.
He may be a figment of our imagination. We don't.
We're going, yeah.
Lord Saw. Is definitely the forgiving type.
To be clear, if that wasn't the deal was we'd take him to Krynn and then beat the crap out of him. I mean, you know, but I was pretty sure we wouldn't have to do that.
As the Grim Harrow filter their way into the gate, returning to their demesne called the Gardens of Decay, they do kind of, as they ride on, they do, of course, continue to stare with hatred.
Guiding bolt.
Yeah. And Lord Soth is absorbed into the card. Merrick's...
Dragon and all.
Okay. Yeah. You would feel that you could brandish this card as an action to summon a sort of vestige of Soth. to.
Yeah, or not. I mean, yeah. We can also not do that.
You summon me. Die.
Yeah.
No, it would force him to be under your command.
Okay, oh, that is fun, though.
He the
we
love
that. Might need that when we're in. Yes, that can, be fun. Can we use him to be our tour guide?
Yeah. That would be awesome.
He's after our
world map. Right, yeah.
Bring him forward as concentration for 1 hour.
We can just tell him to appear.
I'm going
to
tell you right now, it's not the Lord Soth stat block.
No.
It is.
I jump on the back of his dragon.
We can ride dragons?
We have him take us where we need to go.
No. You have him go get the card and bring it to us.
Something I do want to do, though, is... Never mind.
Is tempting. I gave it to Elise, but it is tempting to hold on to that card just so I can talk to it at night and be like, hey, how's the weather in there?
So
working on the Nightlands.
He's clearing the filth off of everything, and he's just like, we got the card?
We do.
Do we go?
First of all, you guys talk about that. I'm grabbing this pun of the gold. I mean,
well, as you make your way over to the gold, you kind of meander past some of the undead that are wreathed in purple fire. You see that purple fire begin to sputter and spout, and some of the ghoulish apparitions dressed in the attire of Canada.
Now, I have to ask a question.
Yes,
which is, it is a common feature of the Mornland. Though, as I said, there are no rules that are permanent in the Mornland, but one of the more common ones is that bodies don't decay.
Mm-hmm.
So my question is, are they rotting and shambling, or do they look as they were
look?
Before?
They look as they would have in death. When alive.
Right.
You get the feeling it might have been battle and magic, yeah, and some of the
I'm just curious how, you know, pictures, are we looking at something rotting, or actually are we looking at something
rotting,
kind
like
of
just damaged.
Very clearly dead.
Yeah, not rotting, but like damaged. Yeah.
So like they got caught in the blast.
Yes. Yeah.
All right.
Lobo's staring at Merrick's, make sure he's okay.
You see them start to kind of list, and one of them just sort of turns.
You have been doing well, I take it.
And the body just kind of collapses over. Just leaving its arm draping on your shoulder.
Merrick puts his hand on his arm. You definitely would have the impression, I mean, like both of you would get this. This is an old mentor of his. And he just does sort of, like I said, he literally puts his hand on the arm and is just sort of sitting there. Are you going to give him a calm emotions?
Yeah, he's just kind of like...
Because I'm getting kind of dependent on that.
He's going to go over. So you got your hand on the mentor, and then Lovell's hand will go on your hand. He's like, you've got a friend with me. No, that's calm emotions.
In a day, you should be
able to... He won't change your emotions, because that's not what Lovell will do. He just calms him.
So, yeah. Merrick's definitely, as I said, stands there for a moment, keeping that. He gets the shot, and which does clearly...
The other Caneth members also start to kind of stumble over, and they just gaze at you.
He kneels down, because you said he fell...
Yeah, he kind of fell over.
He kneels down.
The energy animating them is beginning to die away.
He kneels down, puts the arm back across his body, and says, I'm trying to do better. And as he does, he's actually still working at a sleight of hand of, you know, plus 19 and such. You might not even notice, but he will actually reach down and take something from the body, like basically his pouch. He's just sort of taking something away.
Always remember, never stop moving forward.
You know, even with the common motion, there's a little watery eyes going
on. He'll lean into you and say, when all this is done, we will come help you restore this land. We'll give you back that which you lost.
Yes.
As you have done for me.
Yes.
You feel that invisible pat on your back.
he's just going to, you know, again, very quietly say to him, you know, we're going to build a better world.
And you feel no more animation left in the corpse.
All right. Stands up. All right. Let's get out of here.